Let's continue our discussion of chemical reactions by looking at single replacement reactions. A single replacement reaction takes place when a single element in a compound gets replaced. So an element by itself reacts with a compound, and that element is going to replace something in the compound. The element that was by itself in the reactants is now part of the compound in the products. The element that starts off by itself in the reactants can either be a metal or a nonmetal. It can either take a positive or a negative charge when it goes into the compound. Because of this, you end up with two general formulas for single replacement reactions. In the top case, A is a metal. A would be something on the left-hand side of the periodic table that normally takes a positive charge in an ionic compound. So when it reacts with this compound, it's going to replace the positive element. Remember that we always write positive elements first. So A is trying to replace B. The positive metal is trying to replace the positive portion of the compound. In this case, you can see that A has replaced B. Now A is part of a compound with C, and B is left over by itself. In the bottom case, D is the element that's going to be doing the replacing. In this case, D is a nonmetal. When it goes into a compound, it's going to take a negative charge. So in this case, D is going to try to replace the negative portion of the compound, which would be the thing that is written second. So in this case, D is trying to replace C. So on the product side, you can see where B and D are now forming a compound, and C has been left by itself. Let's look at an example of a single replacement reaction and predict the products. Starting with the top one, I can see where lithium is reacting with sodium chloride. I recognize this as a single replacement reaction because I have an element by itself reacting with a compound. So this element is trying to replace a single element within this compound. In this case, lithium is a metal, so lithium is going to try to replace the metal in the compound. Lithium is trying to replace sodium. When lithium replaces sodium, lithium is now paired with chlorine. Anytime you write a formula for a compound, you should check your charges. Lithium has a charge of +1, chlorine has a charge of -1. There are no additional subscripts needed for this compound. What happened to the sodium within the compound? That's the remaining portion of the reaction. Sodium is left over. Sodium is now by itself. It was bumped out of the compound by the lithium. You should ask yourself, anytime you write that element by itself, is that element a diatomic? In this case, no. Sodium is not a diatomic, so it's fine without any additional subscripts. And then the final thing you want to look at is make sure that the reaction is balanced, and in this case, it is. So this is a single replacement reaction where a single element within a compound was replaced. Before we continue with the examples, recognize that every time an element and a compound come in contact with each other, that does not mean that a reaction is going to take place. In the case of a single replacement reaction, we have a tool that helps us to determine when the reaction takes place, and that tool is called the activity series. There's an activity series for metals, when you have a metal trying to replace another metal, and there's an activity series for nonmetals, specifically for the halogens, when a halogen is trying to replace another halogen. The way the activity series works is that an element higher in the series can replace an element lower in the series. Let's look at some examples of how you can use this to determine whether or not a reaction will take place. In the example we looked at earlier, lithium was trying to replace sodium. Lithium is here in the activity series, while sodium is here. So lithium is higher in the chart than sodium. This reaction will take place the way it's written. Lithium has the ability to replace sodium. In the second example, the element by itself is fluorine. Fluorine is a nonmetal, so fluorine is trying to replace the nonmetal in this compound. Fluorine is trying to replace iodine. So we want to look at the other version of the activity series, the one that's for nonmetals. You want to find fluorine and find iodine. As long as the replacing element is higher in the series, the reaction will take place. In this case, fluorine is higher than iodine, so this reaction will take place. Now let's predict the products. Fluorine comes in and replaces the iodine. So now you have magnesium paired with fluorine instead of with iodine. So that's magnesium fluoride. I do want to point out that this subscript did not come across the reaction. This subscript came from crossing down your charges. Magnesium has a charge of +2, fluorine has a charge of -1. You would cross those charges down to get MgF2. The iodine was left over, so the iodine is alone in the product side now. The iodine has a 2 because iodine is a diatomic. So when you write your compounds, you want to cross down your charges to get the subscripts. And then when you write an element by itself, you do want to check to see if it is a diatomic. The last thing you would want to do is to confirm that this reaction is balanced, and it is. In the next example, the element by itself is lead. Lead is a metal, so lead is trying to replace calcium. The other thing that you could do is make sure that you're finding things that are within the same series. So lead and calcium are both in the activity series for the metals. Lead is right here, and calcium is right here. Lead does not have the ability to replace calcium. Lead is lower in the series. It will not replace calcium. In this example, it's very appropriate to simply write no reaction. This reaction would not take place. You do not need to predict the products. In the next reaction, you have iodine as the element by itself. Iodine is a nonmetal, so it is trying to replace the nonmetal in the compound. Iodine is here in the series. Chlorine is here. Iodine does not have the ability to replace chlorine because it is lower in the series. This is another example where you would write no reaction. That concludes our discussion of single replacement reactions. We've seen how you can recognize them, how you can predict the products, and how you can use the activity series to determine whether or not the reaction will take place. Stick around as we move on to double replacement reactions.